Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
My name is Amanda Clannon, and my dog is an American Pit Bull Terrier, and his name is Buddy, and he is 2.5 years old. I met Leri at some dog shows. She would come in and do, it's like a safe dog program for the puppies. That's the first time I ran into her, and I kind of heard her name throughout the years, and I knew she was a dog trainer, and I had a pup that I started having a few issues with, so I reached out to her to help with some formal training, because I've never done any formal work with any of my dogs before. He's a little bit bigger than most of mine that I'm used to, and he was a little bit wary of people, which I'm also not used to in the breed. Normally they're very overtly friendly and very outgoing, and I knew that I wanted her to basically assess him and to see if I had, if my concerns were going to be an issue, and get a little bit of help in wrangling him, getting control over him before he got too big for me to deal with. I pretty much just dabbled in the obedience for a couple years, and as I started working with her, she does a lot of the sport work, the French ring and the IGP stuff, and I know nothing about it. I've never been involved in it, and so I was kind of watching the work that she's done and other people were doing around me, and she started noticing. She's the first one who noticed right away that she thought Buddy ticked the boxes for her, for what she thought might do pretty well in the sport work, and then decided to go ahead and try our hand at the sport work just to check it out and see how we did and learn a new avenue of exercising and working and developing a dog. I don't really know what Leri saw in Buddy that made him a good candidate for sport work. But I'm still learning all the nuances of what they're actually looking for in the dogs. So I'm putting those pictures together now and kind of getting a better idea of what it is that they're looking for in the dogs. But at first, I really am not sure what was noticed that was different from another dog as to how it was going to work in the sport work. I think it was just my guess that he's a fairly intense dog, and he's got decent drive. He likes to work. He enjoys working. So I think some of those aspects were just would make it a little bit easier to work him than say a dog that was really low drive and didn't want to do anything and didn't have food drive or toy drive. The sport work is a lot of obedience, and I've only started working in the bite work very recently, probably the last couple months. He mostly did obedience for the first year and a half or so of his life. Then I wanted to get a really good handle on the obedience, and I hadn't even made up my mind that I was going to go into sport work. But as we got better and better in the obedience, and I saw that he was really enjoying the work, we decided to take a step further and just start dabbling in it. I don't think you can really separate the two, the obedience and the bite work. I don't know about protection people, because I know there's different degrees of bite work, and I know protection people are gonna be more in a real world situation where they're, you know, police dog has to take down a criminal. So there's a little bit different aspects in that I don't know the nuances on that. But as far as the sport work, as far as what I've experienced so far, the obedience really plays very, very closely and ties very closely into it. I don't think you can have one without the other. The dog really, really enjoys it. He enjoys flying at the decoy and grabbing the sleeve, and you know, he very much enjoys it. I've had dogs that have done weight pull and are weight pull aces, confirmation show champions, dogs that just hike with me. Every dog is kind of individual in my eyes, and when I'm working a dog, I never have a set plan for them, pretty much. I kind of just play around with them, and if I see something in them that they really enjoy or they're gravitating towards, I end up going that route. Like weight pull, I never did weight pull before. I had a dog that liked pulling me on a skateboard, and I thought, he likes to pull, I'll throw him in this competition. So I've kind of always done it that way. And he just has kind of gravitated towards it, and he enjoys it. And so I kind of just am fostering his individual pleasures in life and trying to make him grow from there. I feel far more confident in handling him and being safe with him, and especially putting more and more and more control over him. I feel like I'm learning, I'm feeling his power, I'm feeling what he can do, I'm feeling how he goes, how he moves out, what he does, being able to call him back, being able to get his focus back on me. I feel like I can contain that. And it's a good feeling. It's a good feeling to be able to feel like you can handle something. I'm not in over my head. That's the biggest thing. I never want to be in over my head with any animals that I'm dealing with, because that's problems for everybody and society in general. And I feel like I feel pretty good. I feel like I've got him. And as far as him, I think it's been pretty good for him, because he has kind of a wary attitude, and he's not a mean dog, but he's not overtly friendly like I was talking about before. And I have noticed the wariness has dropped, and I feel like, and this is just him individual, not speaking on the breed, because the breed is generally very overtly friendly and you don't have those kinds of issues. But for him, in his own individual, you know, personality, I feel like he feels more confident. I don't think he feels like anything's threatening anymore. Like, he feels like, oh, this is as bad as it gets. Somebody's gonna whack me with a stick or go, hey, 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 you know. That's what it's about. It's not something that scary. It's not something that bad. And he's traveling around and not having issues and not having problems. But it seems to have kind of leveled him out as far as any issues that I might have had with his wariness. Truly, my end goal, I would like to go into a competition and be like amazing and have Buddy just like kill it out there, and we come away and it's like, yay, he just did so awesome. But my true goal is to just actually get through one, like have him pass. At the very, you know, if we can go on a field and he can just get through it, even if he doesn't do great, if he can actually do the tasks at hand and we can come out of there unscathed, I'm gonna feel like the accomplishment is gonna feel really, really good. But that's basically my end goal, is just to actually do it and survive it and not look like too big of a fool out there. Money coming, money go. I've been at it on the low. Trapping out of where I live. I keep seeing the leaders doing as we talking plans and maybe seeing you. Pull up on you, let me scoop. Nobody here but me and you. Got a little ring to it, turn a thing fluid in the coupe. Where you look, I know it's real. I'm on my shine shit.